Hey, what's up guys, welcome back to the another video. So we are discussing about 3G 4G wireless communication, where we have already covered few topics earlier, like what is meant by MIMO, so how to create a system model for MIMO, and also we have discussed about CISO systems, CMO systems, and the MISO systems, like so we'll be having one transmitting antenna, many receiving antennas, and the opposite case in case of many transmitting antennas and one receiving antenna. And in the last case, we have discussed about single transmitting antenna and single receiving antenna called CISO system. Okay, so this is the continued part of that one, that is 3G 4G wireless communication. So we are covering the whole syllabus in this playlist. So if you have not seen those videos, then you can just check the playlist where you can find each and everything regarding 3G 4G wireless communication. So with all equations we are explaining here. Okay, so with that said, today's topic is to create a mathematical model or to derive the MIMO zero forcing receiver. So I want to find the output expressions for MIMO zero forcing receiver. Right, so we have created MIMO model, then I want to receive the signal at the receiver, then I should have a model where I can remove the noise and I can remove the unwanted signal, and I will be having only the thing which I want. Like if I am transmitting the symbol x1, then obviously at the receiver also I want the symbol x1 as well. But in practical thing, it will be not like that. So we'll be having the symbol x2, x3 up to xt, and the additive noise, white Gaussian noise, that is n1, n2 up to n. T components will be added with our symbol of interest, and they will be also received at the receiver. So to avoid those things, we need a receiver which can filter the unnecessary or noisy things. Okay, so the one of such filter is zero forcing receiver. So why it is called zero forcing is that it forces the noise to become zero. So that's why it is called a zero forcing receiver. Alright, so how it will be done and what are all the equations is involved in this one, we will just see in this video. Okay, so this describes the method by which we can resolve or recover the transmitted signal vector x from the received vector y. So we can recover the transmitted vector x from the received vector y with the help of this zero forcing mechanism. So the received vector can be represented y equal to h into x, where h represents the complex coding fading coefficient channel matrix, that is h11, h12 up to ht star r. So x is the transmitted code vectors and y is the vector which contains the received symbols, right? So those things we have just written here. Then consider a simple scenario where r is equal to t, that is now number of antennas which are receiving will be equal to the number of antennas which are transmitting, right? So to estimate the x, we will be indicating it as the x cap here, and x cap will be equal to h inverse of y. So from this I can write, so if I take it to the left hand side, then it will become h inverse, and as I'm estimating, I will be denoting these things with the help of a cap expression, right? So after that, this is the general equations which we'll be having for the single input, single output, or any general communication channel here. So y1 of k, y2 of k, and yr of k are the transmitting vectors here at time instant k, and this is the channel complex fading coefficient, that is the channel fading coefficients are there. So h11, h12, h1t. So it will be of r cross t, where r is the receiving number of antennas and t indicates the transmitting antennas, and x1 of k, x2 of k, these are the transmitted symbols, and in this case we have assumed that for now the noise is not there. Okay, so what are the things next to be done, just we'll see. Okay guys, so once we have created the general form of our channel, then here the matrix H has more rows than columns, so this type of matrix is called as tall matrix, and due to this structure, so here the matrix H will be called as tall matrix, which we have seen previously. And so here there are more equations than unknown, so we'll go for the choosing vector x which will be reducing the error f of x cap. So generally receiving antennas will be more than the transmitting antenna, so we'll be having more number of unknowns than the number of equations which are available. So we need to go for a method of reducing the noise with the help of an equation, that is error equation f of x cap, right? So in this equation we can see f of x equal to, so this is the error equation which wants to reduce the error between the received vector and the transmitted vector. So this is the received vector and this is the transmitted vector, and it is taking the magnitude of that one, that is y minus hx whole square, right? So after that, what I can do is I'll just simplify these things with the help of some properties which I'll learn in the 3C 4C communication, right? So if it is a square, then I can write like this. So it is a magnitude square, so I can write this quantity into these two things, that is the one which is transpose and x into x transpose I can write. So this is x transpose y minus hx transpose, and it is y minus hx. So after that I will just remove the transpose, so y transpose h transpose and x transpose into y minus hx. So just multiply these things element by element, and here you can see y transpose hx. So this is a scalar quantity actually, guys, so you can get the transpose of this one. So just for simplification we are doing, so this is a scalar quantity, so I can take the transpose of that one, so it will become y transpose transpose, so double transpose will become, will cancel, and we'll be getting y into h transpose into x transpose. So from this one, so I'll just replace this quantity with the help of h transpose, x transpose and y. So other things I will be writing as it is. So after that you can see these two things will be common here, so I'll just add up those three things here, and I will be writing the final equation f of x equal to y transpose y minus 2 h transpose x transpose y plus h transpose x transpose hx. So this is the equation number one, we can say. Then now we want to minimize the error, so we'll be using obviously differentiation, right? So we need to differentiate and equate it to zero so that we can get the x power value where we'll be reducing the, I mean it will be a variable to reduce the other things like noise, right? So we have taken a general example where we can understand how a g of x will be, let us assume that g of x is a function that is depending on the x. So dou g of x by dou x will be equal to dou g of x by dou x1. So each and everything here will be differentiation. So if we differentiate the general form, then the symbols which are there inside that general form, they will also be differentiated. So just we want to infer that one. So that's why we're taking a common example of g of x, right? So here if you assume like c is a column vector, like it will be having coefficient c1, c2, c3 up to ct, so then I can write g of x equal to c transpose x, so where c transpose is having value c1, c2 and up to ct. So if I multiply these with the help of x vector, then I'll be getting c1 x1, c2 x2, then ct xt, right? So if I differentiate these things now with the help of x, I will be getting dou g of x by dou x equal to dou g of x by dou x1, and that is basically the c1, c2 up to c. So that's why c I'll be getting. So the ultimate meaning of this one is c transpose x will be equal to x transpose c. So if you take the differentiation, it will become c, right? So now we will apply the same concept to our case we'll be applying, right? So now using back to our the equation one, that is f of x equal to y transpose y minus 2 h transpose x transpose plus h transpose x transpose hx. So from above equation we'll just take the differentiation of this one, that means we'll be having we have to take the differentiation of each of these individual terms here, right? So first I will take the differentiation of y transpose y with respect to s, so obviously it will become zero because none of these are depending on the x, so it will be like a differentiating a constant, so it will become obviously zero. So that's why I have written zero here. Then I need to take the differentiation of this one, so you can just do the differentiation here, so with the help of u and v rule, so you'll be getting 2h transpose y here, so this is u, this is v, then u into dv by dx plus v into dv by dx. So like this you can do, right? Okay, so for this one you need not to do that one because you can see here 2h transpose y, so these things